Hi everyone, my name is Inhaxed and this is going to be Satisfactory today, continuing the game I've been playing in my previous videos. This is overlooking my main base. Let's see, that's the reinforced iron plate machine that we're looking over there. Closest anyway. It's got one of the fastest types of tier 3 conveyor belts on it just for that section. Some reinforced plates that have been made by the machine. Not nearly enough. We need the we need the reinforced plates to make modular frames, which we're collecting because we need to put them into the cargo of the space elevator and send it up into space, and that will unlock more technologies for us. So that's where we're at. Now I think just trying to make up the last few things to finish the shipment. So collect a few bits and pieces like iron rods, and I will hand make the last stage. Now I could be automating a lot more of the process, and I probably should, because it is getting more and more complex, the objects that I'm being required to make. I would like to actually probably remove most of the machines that I'm currently have laid out here, lay down a foundation and actually build out a properly logical set of conveyor belts where we can manage it a lot better. At the moment I've been manually tasking different machines to make different parts as I need them, which has been working fine so far. I probably could have done this faster, but you know, it's fun anyway. So this is the space elevator. Let's see how much more we need. Looks like we have everything now, which is great. Okay, loaded. Sealed. Wish I could go, but I'm having a lot of fun on the ground here. Okay, time to look at what we've unlocked. Okay, our tier 4 milestone was the only one that's left, is an alternate recipe for the heavy modular frames, which I haven't needed to make any of yet, but it's probably best to do it before I move on. What, new truck? Owing to that, I'm gonna have to plan out building this stuff, I think. Need to start with the oil infrastructure, I think. Interesting. More of the stuff I've been making, like modular frames and motors to get this stuff going. That's probably the one I need to do there. first things first. So I need a few more of those encased beams, I believe they are. And some more modular frames. At least I don't actually have to click every time. I've seen that in some crafting games, that would drive me mad. I'd definitely be building all the assembling machines if that was the case. Might as well clear that out. Looks like we've got enough, just modular frames now. Let's see how many more reinforced plates have been made. Oh good, that should cover it, I think. Might need screws though. Oh no, not screws, pardon me. More than we need, but we're obviously going to need more in the future, so it doesn't hurt. Oh, we don't get launch for that. Let's set our next milestone, because that gives us a running total in the corner of the screen. What we need. Got lots of wire. I was getting so much copper it was clogging up the coal intakes on the coal truck, so I kept having to pull all the copper ingots off the coal conveyors that were trying to feed it to the power stations there to the left. Lots of wire. I could probably fix the layout too if I rebuild everything. I do a lot of jumping over conveyor belts and ducking under them. Now the motors, which are a little bit complex to build. Making whatever it was making. Might have been steel pipes. Probably wire, actually, I think. could have been anything, really. We'll have to see. Get it set up to make some cable. I should have more of these around. They do make it a bit easier. Now, I've got to clear this conveyor belt. After I set it to make cable, these are all steel ingots. Easiest way is just to rebuild it. Always need more screws, it seems. Reinforced plates. Yeah. Really have to bother with. Add the screws in here though, because that makes it run a bit faster. I have noticed the artery reload in the center of the screen. I pre-recorded this, so I'm not quite sure why it took me so long to actually press R. I don't even know if I did press R in the end. We're off on a journey to get some coal. Perhaps. Yeah, I'm not sure where I went now. Maybe might be going to the new watchtower to have a look. Oh no, drive down here and have a look. I saw these mines from the cliff edge, so I wanted to know what they were. I'm not experienced enough to tell from the colour yet. So, iron. and I know there's a power slug there, so I might as well go and get it. Brutal on the poor power slugs, but what can you do? They speed up my factories by 50%, you know. It's definitely a something of a lesson in this game. Another one over on that mushroom rock there, but I can't see how to get up there. I know that later in the game, in fact I think I've unlocked it now, I can have a jetpack, so... Well, I haven't unlocked it, sadly. I guess I've unlocked the ability to get that to you. Push the rock. Is probably enough to be getting on with. Those were the easy ones. And now some motors, which we need massive amounts of screws for. I thought we have a screw making machine right here, but it's also what's feeding our reinforced iron plate machine. And it never has any in storage. A bit of a cut. This is the new lookout tower, that's what I meant to say, which is quite close to the base. It's overlooking the big plain where I found those two iron mines a few minutes ago. They're just below where we are to the right. That's where I picked up the power slug down there. And you can see the other one on the mushroom rock over there. They're amazing looking creatures, those walking creatures, spindly things. I don't see any new creatures down there. There's some strange trees at the top of the cliffs over there, which I'll have to investigate eventually. Sort of curve like tusks or something. Yes, I finally reloaded. Glad I got around to that. Time to do a coal run, I think. I've stopped the automated coal truck because it kept running out of fuel. I need to set up some way to actually refuel it. It isn't terribly difficult, but then I don't see it being crucially necessary at the moment, especially because we're probably about to switch to oil power and I'm only going to need the coal for making steel. Anyway, we've been able to transport enough coal just in while the trucks have been working that it isn't really an issue. But I will go grab some more. Makes a nice break from crafting. Doesn't seem to be any respawn. None of the creatures that I killed around here have come back. Okay, here we are at the coal mine. It should automatically load me up with as much as I can take. Down, and it looks like I get mycelia from it, which is something I've actually been looking for. I didn't really want to go and kill any more creatures to get it. That's how I got the first sample that I had. Some kind of path up there, but it's blocked by the green gas, or fungus, or whatever it is. Here's some new fungus too, the bacon agaric. Interesting. They almost look like nests. I imagine they probably are. Though, if they are, something should come get me at this range. Is probably enough, 82. Usual sample size is 1, 5, or 10, I think one of them was. No space for paleberry. Very sad. I'm definitely missing something in regards to the crafting with the plants, I think. Something I haven't unlocked will hopefully lead me down the path of being able to make useful things from the berries and the nuts. And the mushrooms. space. I guess if I was really keen, I could build a cement ramp up that hill to make the truck faster. Not worry about any of the plants or anything. I'd also like to make the base multi-story, so it's more compact. I have some ideas in mind. I'll have to experiment a little bit. And time for a drop-off. Never noticed this before. It's probably been there since I unlocked the gun. Reload. Not emote. I keep getting the... I think it's the T key next to it. Oh, fumble fingers. Oh, but that is pretty cool. Oh dear. Yes, there we go. Okay, analysis time. Find out the reason for the strange title for this video.
This type of mycelia has strong healing properties. R&D has created a blueprint you can access in Hub Tier 3.
This one's a little bit more truthful than the blue screen of death I tend to see. they still have updates in the future. Thirteen 37 unlicked objects. I wouldn't mind moving this, but it's, I think, the one thing I can't build now. Possibly if I did recycle it, I would be able to build it again, but that may reset it to tier 1, which would not be fun. Not unless it refunded me all of the resources. But that wouldn't really work. Well, time to keep on with our next milestone, I think. Time to do some crafting. Yes. I was considering switching to the earlier milestone to complete it, but now that I've started this one, I really should complete it. Nope, and I have no space. Get rid of some of the junk, like the biomass, the leaves and things. I'm still gonna need to make some space though. Space again. Frames and motors, I think. This should be enough to cover the rest that I need. And a stator. Rotor and stator are both composite things. So I already have some stators, I need to make up some rotors to match. I'm obviously going to need a lot more than I've got. Grab some screws. Discovered that it only pushes out the overflow when it's making them, so there's usually a full load of the commodity inside the machine. We should have a look if that's the case with the reinforced iron machine, reinforced plate. Yes, Let's move some of this junk out of my inventory. Now that I look at it though, I kinda need everything that I'm carrying one time or another. Says with his fingers crossed, I need to make 50, so... I'll try and get this milestone finished before the end of the video. It shouldn't take too long. Flying creature going over again. Hand making the screws can be done, but it's a lot easier to just say have a machine make them. And we should have a bunch waiting here. That should be enough to help us finish. There we go, 15 motors. Okay. Let's load up the module.
Milestone reached. Oil acquisition and refining unlocked. Oil-based products can now be made. Caution, this is a reminder to minimize the chance of expiration during out-of-base activities.
Alright, all done. Well, I hope everyone enjoyed that. Should be another video soon. Hopefully I'll be able to unlock some more of the technologies off-camera and show them to you next time. Have a great day or night, wherever you are. See you next time.